that was a little bit lackluster. I thought there was going to be some kind of moving and things. Hold on a second. I gotta close the Internet Explorer before we play this. Okay, so this is Skyborn. I have no idea what this game is, but I got it a while back. It's a private purchase, bought it for me off my wish list. So let's see what it is. It's an RPG, I know that much. It's about it. I should probably adjust the volume. Another day in paradise, Coggy. Coggy! So what if the sun can't break through the smog? It gives our shop some atmosphere. Sunshine's overrated anyway. Mouse! I just rewired that. I wonder if I can trade you in for a cat, Coggy. Sad face. If robots could make sad faces. Everything okay in here, Claret? Claret, it's such a weird name. Nothing I can't handle. Just a little pest problem. Okay, we've got an important client coming in soon, so you might want to clean things up. Do you see a mess in here? I keep my workspace clean, unlike some people I know. I wasn't talking about your workspace. Your clothes are covered in engine grease. Oh my! I'm not paid to look clean. Wow, this game is really loud. Well, don't say I didn't warn you. Anyway, we need that thing up and running by tomorrow. So get to it! What client cares if their mechanic is clean? And where did I leave my rivet gun? Oh, right. Over there to the left, by the front desk. Hashtag tutorial telling me to walk. System, can we adjust this? Okay, this looks really, really annoying to work with. Hold on while I use the more easy way of working with sound. Well, I'll be surprised if you could have heard me at all earlier, but look, it's a learning process. We didn't exactly know it was going to be that loud. The menu music didn't quite seem that loud at first. I walk really fast, and it kind of makes me feel not okay with this. Corgi. Huh. Well, this seems weird. Looks like something's amiss here, I don't know. Well, well. Looks like we might have a renegade half-breed on the loose. A punch to the gut? Let me go, I'm not a half-breed. I've been through processing already, so lay off. He doesn't have any wings, sir. Some half-seas are light bloomers. Besides, there's more than one way to prove he's not human. Punching him in the gut? What's going on here? We've got a report of a free half-breed in this part of town. You know the law. You're harassing my employee in my shop. Whoa, whoa, take it easy, lady. I think you should leave. Back off, ma'am. Let's not make this official. Oh wow! Get out, get out, get out, get out, get out! Rivets, Jesus. Shooting rivets at people, that is not nice. Typical dirt stomper. You're lucky you've got the client you do. Else you and I would have words. Other than these words. Keep your nose clean, human. Look at me, I got wings, so I think I'm better than you.
Corwin, are you okay?
Nope!
I'm fine. Thanks, Claret.
What makes them think they can treat people that way?
Probably something about their wings, their magic, and the fact that they won the war.
I'm so sorry, Corwin.
I don't know why the Skyborn prefects are coming in here. They've never taken notice of us before. It's okay. Some of them came in the other day, same routine. It's nothing new.
They beat you up daily? Have you told Jake?
Really, it's not a big deal. Please don't concern him with it. I'll clean up around here so you can get back to work.
Well, doesn't that seem strange?
What a mess, Coggy. Well, I need to fix this airship anyhow. and whoever flies it must be the world's worst pilot. The navigation core is completely shot. We're all out, but I should be able to pick up a new one in the city. Oh, I'll be fine. Besides, if I run into trouble, I do know how to use a rivet gun after all. Just need to grab those before I head out. Oi, game. Just keep showing me everything more, don't ya? Two times rivets? Okay, game. Okay. I didn't pay any attention, but you know what? It's a glorified hammer. Oh! Oh! Dual rivet guns! Game of the year already! I'm a machinist. I don't know. Look, I don't know the exact pronunciation of that word. That's a weird word. I got 50 gold coins on me and 539 HP. I'm sort of a badass. Well, Corgi, I gotta go now. RPG adventures tell me I need to search the house before I leave. Just in case I run into some unexpected storyline. We don't know. Look, Final Fantasy was really big on the unexpected, everything's gonna go to shit. Same with Dark Cloud, actually. Dark Cloud did that too. Paid to pay attention, okay? But this place got nothing. I can go. What will we find? Well, we already found a shiny. I'm now level 2! Oh boy, I didn't even do anything! This is an exploration node. Walk into these in order, one of the dogs barking about. These in order to gain experience points towards leveling up. There are dozens of these all over the world. Some are easy to find, some are more hidden. Reward yourself with exploration! Thanks, Reuben. I have no idea where I'm supposed to be going, but I assume... I actually don't know. It's a toss-up between the Industrial District and the Blackstone Industries. I'm assuming the Industrial District's gonna take us to where we need to go, but let's explore a little bit, because I want to know what city we live in. This game is supposed to be steampunk-ish, so that's fun. Hey look, it's one of those winged guys. Oh man, they're so friendly. What's up, lady? Claret Spencer came out of her cave. What brings you to town? Surely it must be about work, work, work. You betcha. Just picking up a few things for a ship in very sad shape. Damn straight. What the frick is going on here? Oh, is this where I'm supposed to be? Is this my objective? You! Speak! Astrid Blackstone! Well, well. Claret Spencer, you're looking rustic. How is the repair shop business faring these days? Doing quite well, Astrid. Pay is good enough. A hard day's work really cleanses the soul. It's what us rustic people do to pass the time. Mm-hmm. Good to hear. Well then, I imagine you're here for widgets or whatever it is you people do. My uncle over there behind the counter would be pleased to assist you. Thanks for being nice to me. I like you too. Long time no speak, Harold. I need a navigation core for an Osprey MK2 yacht. Yacht? Yeah, yacht. Weird ship names, yo! Please tell me you guys have one sitting around.
Osprey nav core. Yep, got one right here. Don't sell these much, they run about 40 bits. But I'll let one go for 30 for Spencer's lovely girl.
Thanks! Who says good looks don't get you anywhere? It's a joke. Everybody has jokes. Did I buy it? Sweet! I'm out! Peace! Huh. Well, this looks ominous. Ow! Who dares to... Oh, great. It's that crazy mechanic again. Oh, great. The pompous Skyborn again. I've had just about enough of your lip, human. Time to teach you some manners. You gonna hit a girl? Bring it on. You'll be sorry you messed with Claret Spencer. Heh, you think I'm afraid of a rivet gun? You've obviously never faced a Skyborn warrior. Oh boy. Combat time. And look, it even has a little side panel that tells you who's going next and shit. That's cool. Yeah, you get doubled on. Okay. Well, this is gonna be fairly, I think, normal. I could just probably... kill them without... Okay, nope. Nope. Doesn't look like it. Let's, do something special to the other guy. That did not do more damage like I suspected it would.
Come on, you two. I'm not having brawling in the streets.
Leave the human to its work. Surely we have more important things to do.
As you wish, sir.
Human, I'm keeping my eye on you, okay? Now I'm gonna fly away back to my home planet.
Boy!
Yeah, you better fly away. Alright, time to finish this airship job. Look at these assholes. Think they're so cool because they can fly? Yeah, well, I can shoot rivet guns. What now? What's in my way? Corgi, you little bastard. Or Coggy, you little bastard. Just standing in my way so I can move. What do you dweebs want? I'm in the middle of something. Claret, I'd like to introduce you to Solomon Chesterford.
Mr. Chesterford, this is my younger sister, Claret. She's our main mechanic here at Spencer Dry Dock and Repair.
Hello there, miss.
Hi.
Since when do I have to deal with the clients?
Well, Mr. Chesterford wanted to see how the repairs are coming along on his airship.
His airship?
Oh, so you're the owner?
Yes, it's been making an odd clanking sound lately. I assume you'll be able to repair it.
The clanking was just one of your problems. The timing belt slipped, causing the engine to misfire, but I also found a bent propeller, worn-out struts, loose lug nuts, and a giant gouge in the hull. This poor girl's been through the ringer. Your pilot should be fired.
Surely I'm not that bad. I've taken at least a month's worth of the best flights courses money can buy.
You did this?
You... Claret, important clients.
Mr. Fancy Pants here is abusing his ship. This model isn't even a year old, and look at the condition it's in.
Anyway, Mr. Clusterford, let's go discuss that business contract right now.
You don't deserve an airship!
Chesterfield. It's Chesterfield, not Clusterfield.
And that's why Jake won't let you run the front desk.
I can't stand it when people don't take care of their machines.
Besides, the guy was such a tool, I could have fixed the airship using him.
Well, I hope he's not too offended. The Chesterfords are in the wealthiest circles. They're even accepted in the Skyborn Society. We could really use their business.
Don't worry, when he sees how smoothly this ship runs after I'm through with her, he'll be back.
Assuming he doesn't crash his ship into the Celestial Palace or something.
Bullet Pony?
I think. I don't know.
Oh my goodness, what are we doing here? We're building a ship. That's what we're doing.
Well, we're not really building a ship. We're fixing an airship, damn it. It's an engine. Or an actual airship? Jesus.
When did we get here? Or did we install the engine? I don't know.
Phew. Just about ready.
Shut up, Coggy.
Oh, we're at a dock.
Look, it's hard to tell these things right away.
Thanks again. Your ship should be ready tomorrow afternoon.
A pleasure, Mr. Spencer. I'm glad we were able to reach an agreement.
And I'll look forward to a fresh slew of insults on tomorrow from your oh-so-charming sister.
Farewell!
Whee!
Slowly.
Claret, don't you think that just this once you could have tried to make a good impression?
Who does that character remind me of?
Not this character, but the other guy's model.
Sorry, Jake.
That guy just got on my nerves. I can't read.
Yeah. Claret, there's something I need to talk to you about.
What now?
I don't think you're gonna like it much.
Okay.
In fact, I probably should have talked to you a little sooner.
Just tell me already. You're freaking me out.
I'm selling the shop to Sullivan Chesterford.
What?
And the mouse is gone! The rat has left!
Look, I know you like to focus on your work, but look around you. Big things are happening in this city, and I can't sit here fixing widgets forever just watching the world change.
I have to go be a part of it.
But you can't sell the shop.
I've already made the deal and the contract is signed.
Sorry, Claret.
How could you? This is our home. Look at all we've accomplished here, especially after Mom and Dad walked out on us.
Can't blame them. They probably didn't want to be stuck here either.
How could you say that? Are you going to leave me too?
Now hold on a second. I've made sure you'll be all taken care of. Trust your big brother.
What?
Holy cow!
I've never seen so much money!
Mr. Chesterford and I spent hours working out the deal. In addition to you getting half of a very generous sum of money from the shop sale, your half of a very generous sum of money from the shop sale, there's a way you can keep working here and run the place.
Really? How?
Simple. You become Mrs. Chesterford.
You have got to be kidding.
Nope. We talked about it. It took some haggling, but he's already agreed.
You sold me as part of the shop?
No. I meant I had to haggle to get him to take you. Except more angry and loud, but I'm not. Look, I can't do that kind of work. Come with me, Coggy. Actually, no, fuck off, Coggy. I don't want you right now.
God, you're more annoying than a cat. Homeless, unemployed, humiliated. My brother is an idiot. How could he do this to me? And what made him think I'd marry that Chesterford guy? That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
But he looks suave!
Shut up, Coggy.
Guess there's only one thing to do.
Come on, Coggy. I've got a plan.
We're gonna make him hate us.
No, we're not. The airship is still in the work bay and is flight ready.
Let's go. We're gonna steal Mr. Chesterford's airship.
He'll never know. Corwin, get the hell out of my way.
Corwin, I was just getting a drink of water.
Really? Jake told me the news.
Oh. I'll pretend I didn't see you.
You will? My hair's shorter than it is on my actual character model.
Every person should be free to make their own choices.
Thanks, Corwin.
Oh, one more thing. Could you give this to Jake when you see him?
Goodness, isn't this your share of the sale money?
He's gonna need it.
Take care, Corwin.
I'ma steal your airship! Why is there an inn in this airship? How rich is this guy's freaking stupid...
Oh, this is almost too easy. Jake is going to be furious.
And then Mr. Chesterfield walks in, right?
No?
Alright, fine. Fuck that guy. We don't need him. Fuck you too, Coggy. Why the hell? Oh, wait, he is here.
Good. Looks like everything's here.
What the?
Slide.
Ow, that'd have to hurt.
Zounds!
Best expression ever for a shock.
Thud? No, there should be no thud. I triple-checked the engine earlier.
Uh-oh.
You! What are you doing here? The shop closed hours ago.
It's my ship.
What are you doing flying it?
I was only...
Look, Jake told me about your little contract. I've decided it is unacceptable. I'm taking the ship as compensation.
Thief?
How dare you? We have a signed agreement. Stormrook Sky Patrol drones? I ran straight into them!
Now who's the bad pilot?
Your fault for distracting me. Blast. How am I going to explain this to Jake and the city guard?
Surely we can resolve this in a civilized manner.
Oh, now you want to talk about it? A little late, the drones are closing in.
Bother. Let's fight them off.
Fight them? I thought you...
Come now, you don't want to be arrested for theft and kidnapping, do you?
No, but...
Well, then let's kick some ass!
I guess I have no choice. Coggy, take the wheel. It's probably the worst decision I've ever made. But we'll do it.
Here they come. Let me take the brunt of their attacks. Make sure my threat is higher than yours, Claret. They'll always attack whoever has the highest threat.
What do you mean, threat? Why can't we just blast these out of the sky?
You draw attention to yourself by dealing damage. If your threat gets too high, hang back and defend while I try and draw them away from you. Just be careful and don't get yourself killed.
Alright, that was weird.
Well, I'm injured. Do I have anything useful in hand?
No, I don't. Well, my threat's lower than yours, so I can safely fire away.
And I'm gonna do the non-typical RPG thing of attacking multiple people.
Oh, great.
So, it looks like Claret does more damage than him, which puts her threat above his. Yeah. Well, you should probably guard Claret.
Let Sullivan kick some ass!
Huh. They do a lot of damage. I'm not really sure how much I feel. Words. Although Sullivan would be much better off if they didn't keep exposing weakness on him. Little dicks.
Die, Skybots! Die!
Oh crap, now she's...
generates extra threat! Perfect for what we want in here.
I need to continue to guard. I have no idea what that EN is, but I'm assuming I can find out soon enough.
Keep guarding, Claret, before you get killed because you suck currently. But we'll fix that!
By killing him, hopefully. Maybe we'll gain a level, we don't know.
Level up!
He's higher level than me. What a dick.
And now I know expose weakness! Ha ha!
And so we gain. We gain some intelligence, some agility points, and some strength points. We have almost no defense. We suck. I say, Claret, you're a dab hand with those rivet guns.
Thanks.
Why are you helping me all of a sudden? It never helps to antagonize your kidnapper and all that.
I haven't kidnapped anybody!
That's wonderful news. You'll return my ship and my person to the dock, then.
No way am I going back. I'll have to dump you somewhere else.
Oh, are you my new chauffeur? We ought to discuss your wages.
Look here, Sully Ford. We both want you off this boat.
Fine, I'll let you off wherever you want, but I'm keeping the ship. I even left a bunch of money with Jake to pay for it. Well, if that's the case, let's make this legal, shall we? Fly me to Uptown, and we can go to the airship registry office and record the sale.
You do that?
Why not? I can always buy another.
Well, I guess you can, huh? Sounds like a deal!
Huzzah! Now we're at the Uptown airship docks!
Yeah, you better follow me.
Huh?
Surely you've been to Uptown before. I came up here once with Jake and Corwin when we needed some parts for a job, but I didn't see much.
Fear not. I am a directional genius. Just head into town, and the registry office will be all the way to the west, right next to the town square.
Question, I'll update it. Oh, cool, we finally healed.
Alright, Sullivan, tell me what your EN is. Oh, nope, not gonna tell me. EN. EN. EN.
Have no idea what that means. Well, screw that then. Hello, sir!
Okay. Thanks for, Ew. Some more of these guys. These Skyborn
assholes. Well, like in every good RPG, I better scour the world and see if I can find anything useful.
Nope, can't find anything useful. Alright, well, you know what? Randomly clicking doesn't always work out for you. Okay? It's not how it works in every game. What's this?
I forgot my objective of what I'm supposed to be doing. Why is this box a different colored?
Interesting. Intriguing.
Ho there! Are you new around here?
I am! Okay, let's just quickly inside the inn. Adventurer's school? Oh, cool.
That's all you're telling me?
Peace!
Who the hell are you?
Uptown is a bit more ritzy than the rest of the city. Well, except for the Skyborn area, of course, because the Skyborns are dweebs. As we all know.
Oh my goodness, there's so much stuff now.
Here's debuffs. HP, HP. Buys one character from knockout status. Look, let's pick up a couple of potions. I'm picking up a lot. I lied when I said just a couple. Who are you? Never mind. This is the inn, but that's not where I need to be, right?
Oh man, auto control.
Guards milling about again. Could it be the Red Specter?
Why don't the guards catch him already?
Bloody hell. What is it? What's going on? The Red Specter. He's something of a local menace.
What does he do?
Petty crime, usually. Vandalizing public property, harassing the Skyborn prefects and the like. He's been getting bored of late, though. Why don't the guards catch him?
Oh, they're trying. So far, none of...
There he is! The Red Specter! Whoop! Hey, that wasn't nice. I was just minding my own business. Go, kobold!
Run, you fool! Goodness, they're right on your tail. You're really into this.
Yes, yes, big fan. He's so stylish.
Jump! Get out of there!
Ow! Oh god, my legs!
Dirt stompers should stay in the dirt. I don't see how a bumbling fool like you has managed to avoid the guards so long, but it ends now.
Woohoo!
Peace! Oh, they even had that, like, the Zelda run, like, sound. Funny.
You sure do like criminals, huh?
That's why I'm trying to get married to you.
You inept brigands do have a sort of charm, I suppose.
I am not a criminal, other than the fact that you stole my airship, but you know what, whatever. Not a big deal.
And here's the registry. Luckily, it has a glowing door. It's actually really nice. Every game should have some way of telling me where to go, because I'm an idiot.
Good sir, record this bill of sale for us, if you would.
Not too many of us can say they own an airship.
Lucky girl you are.
Done and done.
That's it then.
Certainly. The ship is yours. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Allow me to walk you back to the docks. I think I can find my way- No, no. I insist. Directional genius, remember?
Right. Okay, whatever then.
Where are we going now, sir?
I'm surprised that I even remembered how to get back here, because I wasn't paying attention the first time I walked through.
Splendid indeed.
Why do I feel like something bad's about to happen here?
Of all the bloody messes... something wrong? My dear, I'm afraid I must apologize.
What for?
Abysmal timing. I don't...
Guards! Guards! Help!
Are you trying to toy with us, human? Watch your tongue! That's Chesterford's, Chesterford's kid.
Fine, is there a problem, boy?
Arrest this woman.
What?
She's a thief and a kidnapper.
Throw her in prison.
Right away!
Let me go! That ship's mine, I've got the deed right here. We had a deal, you liar!
Ooh, allegations. Shouldn't be making them.
Hey, Coggy, you're here too.
That overdressed, lily-livered bastard! Hope he chokes on his cravat. How dare he accuse me like that?
Guilty? Of course I'm not. Not anymore, anyway. We worked it out. Why'd he wait so long to call the guard?
They'll have to let me go once they see my name on the deed, on the airship deed. If they even bother reading it. This is so unfair.
Let's see. Claret Spencer, charged with theft and kidnapping.
I'm not guilty. I demand a trial.
Trial? Hilarious. Did you hear that?
Yes, I did, sir.
Riveting. You're not as fun as I was hoping you'd be whenever I signed you as a warden.
I'm sorry, sir.
If you want to get out of here, human, you're gonna have to tell me what I want to know. Where's the location of the rebel hideout?
The what?
Who is the leader of the rebel movement?
How would I know?
Give me names, then. Who's involved?
I don't know.
She's obviously been trained to resist interrogation.
So she may not be involved at all. The report says she was accused by one Sullivan Chesterford, the leader of the Rebellion Brigade, probably.
The spoiled Chesterford brat! I see. What a bother.
You take this one, Yassian.
I have real criminals to deal with. Ho ho!
You're an idiot. Oh, I can't give you that voice anymore because you look too cool for it.
Damn it! I was making fun of you.
Claret Spencer, is it?
Yeah, so?
Interesting. Excuse me a moment.
Whee!
I can't believe this.
Coggy's the rebel leader! Take him away!
Jake!
So you do know each other.
Are you a prisoner? Claret, I don't know.
Perhaps you weren't listening when I ordered you to remain silent.
Backhand, that actually turned him wow,
nice! You've got an arm!
Transfer this one to the fortress. I want him under maximum guard.
What's your deal? My brother didn't do anything.
I'm afraid that's not the case. He was discovered this morning, attempting to conceal a half-breed.
Surprise.
But that's not what I wanted to discuss with you. You see, you're not the only one who wants to escape this prison. I've come up with a plan that would benefit us both.
I don't need a plan. I'm not even guilty.
Your brother is.
Well, shit, you've got me there.
Not to worry. I can help him. But I will do so only if you agree to work with me.
Oh, are you gonna let me escape and then blame it on the warden? Because he's an idiot, let's be honest. He is dumb.
What is it that you want?
The warden wants to expose the rebel sleeper cells gathering here in the city. Doing so would grant him great prestige among the upper echelons of my people. Unfortunately for him, that prestige will, inexorably, be mine. While he chases Ghost, I will focus my attention on a more practical problem. The Red Spectre.
I already told you guys, I'm not involved with anything like that. Hell, this is only my second time in Uptown.
Just listen. I've studied his movements. I'm certain that the Red Spectre is not only affiliated with the rebels, quite intimately, but is planning a jailbreak here. I will transfer you to a new cell. When the Red Spectre attempts his jailbreak, you should be able to escape with the rest of the prisoners he's after. From there, it's simple. Let him take you to his hideout, discover his identity, and report back to me. If you succeed, you and your brother will go free. But I... Or you can refuse, and your brother will die. Who knows how long you'll rot in here.
You don't leave me with a whole lot of choices.
That's kind of the point. Let's go.
Can I wait, Coggy?
Ah, fuck you, Coggy. No one likes you anyway. You'll find your way over here.
You probably weren't even in jail. Coggy, you're dumb.
Don't speak of our agreement to anyone, or this whole thing will fall apart. I look forward to hearing from you.
You gotta be rough, now the suspect. Corwin! Corwin! Corwin!
Well, I guess that,
Guess we'll deal with all this next time. Only on Dragon Ball Z, also known as Skyborn. Without dragons, without a ball, and without a Z. There is no Z in Skyborn, I hate to break it to you. It's unfortunate. English language spelling sucks, I know.